The Nola Til Ya Die building, that's across the road from the American Can Company. But this is, it looks like they're starting to get under control. For a while there, it was huge.
Yeah, the flames were so high. Katie said she counts 10 to 12 fire trucks there, and they've been trying to put out the flames for at least 30 minutes that we know of.
The good thing is there's a fire truck.
Yeah, you've got to wonder if this is more than just one building.
Yeah.
So it's on now. All right, let's go out to Katie Steiner, who was out there live. And Katie, can you get a view? Is it one building or several buildings out there? Because there's a number of buildings around that area.
Yeah, there's a lot of buildings here. So what we know is it is definitely the Nola Till You Die building. Now, the thing about this building is the Canal Furniture Liquidators is in the back of the building as well. So we don't know if that business is affected. But around here, you have a lot of different warehouses that are pretty close together. So we haven't really been able to get a chance to walk around to see exactly what is burning as of right now. But we do know that the Nola Till You Die building, the one that company is in, that is burning as of right now. And we assume that the Canal Furniture Liquidators also are affected because they're in the same building. So you're looking at that right now, but finally, crews are able to make a little bit of progress. You can still see flames coming out of the roof of this building, but not nearly as many flames as we were seeing before. And the smoke plume also has gone down significantly. So that fire truck, that ladder that you're watching right now, that water has been going down onto that warehouse for at least 20 minutes to a half an hour at least. And that's just the time that we've been here. Because can see that they are making significant headway, and they also added another ladder up there. You can just barely see it through the trees of all that water coming on the back side of the building as well. So firefighters have a lot of people here. There are a lot of trucks that are around here fighting this from multiple different angles, simply because it is such a huge, massive fire that has been burning from a very long time. We heard from someone about 45 minutes ago to an hour ago that said that they saw this fire. It's huge. They said that this is one of the biggest fires they've ever seen. You can see all of the flames just coming out. So we're not able to see exactly how massive this fire is, how many buildings are affected by this, but we do know that the Nola Till You Die building, that one is affected. Now, Nola Till You Die is a clothing store. You have a lot of New Orleans specific t-shirts and hats and things that come out of this that are sold here. We do know that this was not planned to be open today. Nola Till You Die is open on Wednesday to Saturday, so wasn't supposed to be open today, and it wasn't open yesterday, but fire crews are going to be here throughout the morning and into the night trying to figure out exactly what this happened after they knocked this down. Now, I want to show you the area as well. We are very, very close to the American Can Company. There's a bunch of apartments here. You can see that building is not affected, but in the parking lot, you are looking at a couple of fire trucks that are here trying to assist, trying to help out with this fire. But the apartment complex is fine. That has not been affected, but you can just see how close it is here to this fire. You have a lot of buildings that are around this area. There's a post office around here, but again, we haven't been able to see exactly how many buildings are affected. But I mean, you can just imagine this fire is so big, it's so hot, there's so many flames. Even if there wasn't, this fire didn't hop building to building, it probably still did affect buildings around here simply because it was so hot. But that's why you're gonna have firefighters here all around this building. They are taking a defensive stance, and as soon as they get this knocked down, as soon as they get all of the flames extinguished, the firefighters will be able to go in. They will be able to start that investigation to figure out exactly what happened and how this happened and when it happened. We know it happened overnight. We're guessing it happened around 4 because we started hearing fire trucks come out here about 5:15 this morning. So we're not exactly sure what time the fire crews were called out here, but you can just see how massive this flume of smoke is. And that is significantly smaller than what it was when we first got out here. But you can see these flames continuing to come out of the roof of this fire. But you can see that fire crews have made significant progress, and now they're starting to put a third ladder on it there too. You can see it's the third ladder there. So you've got 1, 2, 3 ladders that are pouring water onto this building, trying to knock down these flames. They have made significant progress, but they have to continue throughout the morning trying to knock down these flames. It's just, Eric and Leslie, such a huge building that is just completely engulfed in flames. I mean, we saw flames pouring out of the entire building, and this thing is very long, very wide, so you can just see how difficult it has been here for firefighters who are trying to knock out a fire at the Nola Til Ya Die building, which is where they sell clothes, clothing items, hats, t-shirts that are very specific to the city of New Orleans. But we're going to send it back to you all in the studio, guys.
All right. And as you mentioned, it was for a while so huge. Those flames were lighting up the night sky. The plumes of smoke could be seen from miles around.
They've made a lot of progress in an hour.
Yeah. And Duke Carter is also out there. Duke, what are you seeing right now?